गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
ओके, सो सेकंड प्रॉब्लम ऑन वैल्यूएशन ऑफ इन्वेंटरी ऑन फॉलोइंग द बोथ मेथड्स इको एंड वेटेड एवरेज मेथड। टेक डाउन द प्रॉब्लम। निधि इंडस्ट्रियल सप्लायर्स, निधि इंडस्ट्रियल सप्लायर्स गिव्स यू द फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन, गिव्स यू द फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग वन ऑफ देयर stores item for the month of June 2019. Stop. On 1st June, stock in hand was 1,600 units. At the rate of rupees 40 each. The following information is given. Now make the three columns. Date, units, and the rate. So date column, 3rd June 2019. Units 1,200, and the rate is rupees 41 each. Next date, 10th June 2019. One thousand units. At the rate of rupees 42 each. Rate column, 42 each. Next date. 18th June 2019. 400 units column 400, and ₹43 each. ₹43 each. Next date, 24th June 2019. 1,200 units. The rate is ₹44 each. The next June, date 30 June 2019. 400 units. 400 units. At the rate of 45 each. At the rate of ₹45 each. Next line. Following issues were made. Again, next line. 2nd June 2019. Eight hundred units. The next date, 9th June 2019. 1,000 units. Next date, 16th June 2019. 600 units. Next date, 23rd June 2019. 200 units. Next, 29th June 2019. 300 units. 300 units. Paragraph. You are required to prepare. Stores ledger account. For the month of June 2019. Under FIFO method. And weighted average method of stock valuation. So in this problem, purchases and issues are separately given. So purchases are given in the table, and after that, issues which are to be made, that are given date wise, and the how many units are to be issued. So give the heading in the books of Nidhi Industrial Suppliers, in the books of Nidhi Industrial Suppliers, stores ledger account into bracket FIFO method so the 9 and 2 columns separately, that is combined 9 columns are there, and date and particulars are the separate columns. So total 11 columns are to be prepared. So first column date, second column particulars, then another main column, first line purchases, and to the next line under the purchases, quantity, rate, and amount. 3 columns are there, quantity, rate, and amount. Then another column, issues. Again, 3 sub columns are there, quantity, rate, and amount. Quantity, rate, and amount. And the last column is balance. Again, into that, 3 sub columns, quantity, rate, and amount. Quantity, rate, and amount. So as per the information given, the date of sequence is to be taken into consideration. Not only purchases are to be recorded first and the issues are to be recorded again afterwards. So how many purchases are there on the particular date, and date-wise sequence is to be considered. So in the date column, 1st June 2019, this is the first date, 1st June 2019. In the particulars, opening balance. So purchases column, all columns are --. Issues columns are also --. And in the balance column, quantity 1600 and the rate is 40. Rate column 40. So amount column 64,000. Now, after 1st June, the 2nd June is given as a supply or issues. So next date, 2nd June 2019, in particulars, issues, now purchase column, again all the columns --. In the issue column, quantity 800. Now in the FIFO method, the rate of the first in that is to be considered. So opening balance rate is to be right there, 40. 800 into 40, amount is 32,000. Now the balance remain out of 1,600, 800 are issued, means 800 units are in balance. Quantity 800, rate 40, amount is 32,000. Then another date is after 2nd, there is a 3rd June 2019. In the particulars column, purchases. In the purchase column, units are 1,200. Quantity 1,200 and the rate is 41. So amount is 49,200. Varche 48 ani varche 1200. So 49,200. In the issue column, dash dash dash, quantity, rate, amount, dash dash dash. Now opening balance is to be kept as it is. First balance is 800, rate is 40, and the amount is 32,000. Now additional purchases are to be recorded in balance column. 1,200 quantity, rate 41, amount is 49,200. Now after the 3rd June, there is a 9th June date, which comes as a sequence. So in the date column, 9th June 2019. In the particulars, issues. So purchase column, quantity dash, rate dash, amount dash, and in the quantity, the opening balance, that is balance which is there, total quantity is 1,000. So we can record it as first in, first out, first of all 800 units, unit column 800, rate is 40 and amount is 32,000. Now another 200, again in the quantity, that means total issues are 1,000. From the first lot it is 800, from the another balance it is taken 200, so total comes 1,000. So for the 200 quantity, rate is 41 and the amount is 8,200. Now the balance column, the quantity of the 1,200 is balance there, but we are used 200. So again in the balance, quantity 1,000, rate 41, and the amount is 41,000. So after the 9th June. The 10th June is the date. Next date column, 10th June 2019. Now on this date, there is a purchases. So particulars, write their purchases. In the purchase column, quantity 1000. Quantity 1000. And the rate is 42. Rate is 42. So amount is 42,000. Amount is 42,000. So no issues are on that date. So issue column, quantity dash, rate dash, amount dash. The balance to be kept as it is 1000 in the quantity. Rate is 41, amount is 41,000. And now on this date, whatever may be the purchase, that again record in the quantity 1000, rate 42, and the amount is 42,000. Amount is 42,000. So after the 10th June, the next date is 16th June. Date column 16th June 2019. There is an issue. So particulars, write issue. Purchase column, three columns, dash, dash, dash. Now issues are made 600 units. Issues are made 600 units. So FIFO method, from the first 1000, we can use 600 in the issue column, quantity 600, rate is 41, and the amount is 24,600. Amount is 24,600. Now in the balance column, out of 1,600 are issued. So balance remain 400. Rate is 41. And the amount is 16,400. Now another balance is remain as it is. 1,000. Rate is 42. And the amount is 42,000. Amount is 42,000. Now after the 16th June, purchase date is given 18th June. So date column 18th June 2019. In the particulars, purchases. So the purchase quantity column 400, rate is 43, so 400 into 43, amount is 17,200, so issue column dash dash dash, no issues are there. Then balance is to be kept. As it is. आता आपल्याकडे जेवढा बॅलन्स होतं त्याच्यामध्ये पहिल्यांदा इश्यू करायचे सॉरी परचेस केलेले आहेत त्यामुळे बॅलन्सचा काय प्रश्न नाही. जसे पूर्वीचे आहे तसेच लिहा. 400, रेट 41, अमाउंट 16,400, मागचे 1000 ची क्वांटिटी अजून जशीच्या तशी आहे 1000 रेट 42 एंड द अमाउंट इज 42,000. आता ऍडिशनल परचेस 400 रेट इज 43 एंड द अमाउंट इज 17,200. So after the 18th June, next date is 23rd June. Date column 23rd June 2019. In the particulars, issues are there. Issues. The issues are only 200 units. So purchase column, all columns dash dash dash. Issue column, quantity 200, rate 41, and the amount is 8,200. Now in the balance column, out of 400 first, 200 are issued. That means balance remain 200. Rate 41, amount is 8,200. Now another two kept as it is. बाकीचे दोन जसे ज्या तसे ठेवायचे. Quantity 1000, rate 42,000, and the amount is 42,000. The next 400, rate 43, amount 17,200. 17,200. Now after the 23rd June, the next date is 24th June 2019, which is purchase date. So in the particulars write purchases. In the quantity of purchase column, 1200. Rate is 44. 1200 multiplied by 44, 52,800. 52,800. So issues column dash dash dash. Now the balance column kept the last balances as it is. 200, rate is 41, amount is 8,200. Then quantity next 1000, rate 42, amount 42,000. Another 400, rate is 43, amount is 17,200. And now on this date, additional purchases are there, 1,200, amount is 44, rate 44, and amount is 52,800. 52,800. So after the 24th June, 29th is the date of issue. Next date, 29th June 2019. In the particulars, write issues. Purchase column, all the columns, dash, dash, dash. Now issues are, 29th issues are 300. Now 300 are to be used. That is first 200 are in the balance. So write 200 as it is. Rate is 41 and 8,200 amount. Now the next 1000 quantity use the 100 in the quantity 100 rate is 42 and the amount is 4200. Now the balance is remaining from the 1000 quantity we are issued 100. That means 900 quantity rate is 42 and the amount is 37,800. Other balances are kept as it is, 400 rate 43, amount 17,200, and the another balance is 1,200 rate is 44, amount is 52,800. Now the last date is purchase. So 30 June 2019. In the particulars, write purchases. Now purchase column, quantity 400. Rate is 45. So 400 into 45, amount 18,000. Amount 18,000. Now in the issue column, quantity dash, rate dash, amount dash. And the balances are to be kept, last balances as it is. 900, rate is 42, amount is 37,800. The another balance was 400, rate is 43, amount 17,200. Again another balance 1,200 units, rate is 42, amount 52,800. And they additionally purchase on this date 400, rate 45, and the amount is 18,000. So this is a balance on 30th June and the amounts on the 30th June. So next line la liha pude. On 30th June 2019, he table cha nantar khali lihayche. The problem is over. On 30th June 2019, quantity of stock, sagalya balance chi total kara. 900, 400 and 1,200. 2,900. Quantity is 2,900. And the amount of the same is, now make the total of all the amounts. 37,800, 17,200, 52,800, and the 18,000. Sagalyanchi total kara.
Ek lakh panchvis hazar aatshe.
ओके आता सेम आपल्याला वेटेड एवरेज मेथड नुसार सोल्यूशन करायचं आहे. आता हाच कंटिन्यू करू का फिनान्शियल अकाउंटचा घेऊ, घरी तुम्हाला हे जमेल का? वेटेड ॲव्हरेज मेथड नुसार त्याचा फॉर्म्युला सांगतो. जे जे बॅलन्स असतील जेव्हा इश्यूचा डेट येतो त्या इश्यूच्या डेटला बॅलन्स क्वांटिटीची टोटल करायची, टोटल ऑफ क्वांटिटी ऑफ बॅलन्स अँड टोटल ऑफ अमाऊंट, दोघांची काय बॅलन्सला असेल ती, त्यानुसार जर ओपनिंग बॅलन्स नंतर लगेच इश्यू असेल तर तिथं पहिलाच रेट लागू होईल. तिथं एकच अमाऊंट असेल फक्त बॅलन्समध्ये 1000 युनिट्स 40 रुपीज, आणि इश्यू लगेच असतील 400-600 तर त्याला रेट काढायची गरज नाही, ओल्ड रेट इज टू बी अप्लायड. पण बॅलन्समध्ये जर दोन रेट अस म्हणजे क्वांटिटीज असतील आणि दोन अमाऊंट्स असतील तर टोटल ऑफ क्वांटिटी मध्ये, आणि द फॉर्म्युला इज टू बी यूज फॉर दॅट, टोटल अमाऊंट अपॉन टोटल क्वांटिटी, त्याच्या प्रमाणामध्ये त्याचा रेट फ्रॅक्शनमध्ये घ्यायचा. फ्रॅक्शनमध्ये घेताना 0.50 पुढे असेल तर नेक्स्ट फिगर घ्यायची, 42.50 असेल तर आपण 43 रुपये घेऊ शकता. त्या पद्धतीनं फक्त राऊंड फिगर घ्यायची, एवढं लक्षात ठेवायचं, आणि खाली नोट द्यायची राऊंड फिगर्स आर टू बी कन्सिडर्ड, म्हणजे आपल्या उत्तराला सपोर्टिंग मिळेल. मला वाटतं तुम्हाला हे घरी जमेल ना?
हो सर.
हा काहीच अडचण नाही, फक्त वेटेड ॲव्हरेज मेथड खाली कंसात म्हणायचं. बाकीच आता मी तुम्हाला ह्याच्यामध्ये ऍडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन मध्ये लेफ्ट हँड साइड राईट हँड साइड काय दिलेलं नाही ते लिहा. पहिला असतं लेफ्ट हँड साइडला काय काय असणार, नेम ऑफ द मटेरियल, त्यानंतर कोड नंबर, देन लोकेशन अँड बिल्ड नंबर, आणि राईट हँड साइडला असेल मॅक्झिमम लेवल डॅश डॅश डॅश, मिनिमम लेवल डॅश डॅश डॅश, आणि रिऑर्डरिंग लेवल डॅश डॅश डॅश. म्हणजे हे स्टोअर्स लेजर अकाउंटच्या ओपनिंगमध्ये विच कॉलम्स आर टू बी देअर हे जर ऑब्जेक्टिव्हमध्ये विचारलं तर तुम्हाला लेफ्ट हँड साइड राईट हँड साइड काय काय असेल कॉलम ते लिहिता आले पाहिजेत. ते सुद्धा तुम्हाला 2 मार्क मिळवून देतील. जर प्रश्न विचारला मल्टी चॉईस क्वेश्चन तर व्हॉट आर दी लेफ्ट हँड साइड कॉलम्स फॉर द इन्फॉर्मेशन अँड व्हॉट इज द राईट हँड साइड इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन द स्टोअर्स लेजर, तर तुम्हाला हे सिक्वेन्सनी लिहिता आलं पाहिजे. उगीच आपलं बिल नंबर पहिल्यांदा घेतलं, पुन्हा मटेरियल नेम घेतलं, पुन्हा कोड नंबरच्या ऐवजी लोकेशन घेतलं आणि शेवटी कोड नंबर घेतला तर दॅट इज ऑल्सो रॉंग, ते सुद्धा चुकीचं ठरेल. तर घरी तुम्ही हा प्रॉब्लेम सोडवा. सांगितलेल्या पद्धतीनं बॅलन्समध्ये जर दोन क्वांटिटीज असतील आणि दोन अमाऊंट्स असतील तर त्यांची टोटल करायची, आणि अमाऊंटच्या टोटलला क्वांटिटीच्या टोटलनी भागायचं, आणि जो रेट येईल तो रेट इश्यूला ॲप्लिकेबल करायचं. फक्त इश्यूच्या बाबतीमध्ये रेट ॲप्लिकेबल करायचा, बाकीचं परचेसचे रेट बदलायचे नाहीत. परचेसचे रेट आर टू बी सेम, रेट इज द सो अँड सो अँड अमाऊंट इज द सो अँड सो. तो अशा पद्धतीनं थोडं त्याच्यामध्ये करा. तर आत्ताचा पिरियड आपण संपूया, तुम्हाला दुसरा पिरियड असेल कुणाचा तरी. माझा आता थर्ड पिरियड आहे ना, नंतरचा तो आपण फायनान्शियल अकाउंटिंगचा घेऊ. ओके okay?